So I'll come across to you, but please make sure that your questions are very short. Come. It has to be one line. And try to address it.
Okay. Yeah. So, sir, Mrinal sir, just he said that agar dukan chalta hai toh chalne do. So, that is the main concept behind yellow journalism. Sir, if you say that someone is not good, I'm sorry, but almost everyone who is watching the news channel is gonna believe that it's not good. So, sir, can you just, why don't you say both the sides and let the those who are watching, let them decide is it true or not? And not just give out the judgment yourself.
I'll pass this question to Mr. Arnab Goswami. He will reply in a minute.
No more elaboration? So, I'll just add one line.
Akash?
Yeah, yeah, Kartikeya, go ahead.
You know, I'll simply put it. You see, when we talk about any broadcast operation, we are talking about business. Let's be very clear about that. We are in this event. Look at the brands who have sponsored it. The money has to come, you know, the bread has to be buttered. So when we talk about, it's not a bad word, TRP is not a bad word. Please understand, when we talk about viewership, it has a revenue model. You know, nothing survives without a revenue model. Now, there is a tyranny of revenue model, but that's what it is. So now, for example, you will say, what is the alternative? There are alternatives. Crowdfunding was one alternative. Barack Obama redefined the way elections are contested. I think out of 1 billion, he, in 2008, 415 billion came from crowdfunding, amounted to $86 per person,
yeah.
You know. So even Congress, which is battered, is trying crowdfunding here. So that is one. Secondly, for example, you go to some brilliant newspapers from UK and websites from India, they are trying crowdfunding, but TV models, big newspaper models can't subsist.
Just 30 second addition to Kartikeyan. Please remember the word called FTA. I don't need it. Please remember the word called FTA in television industry. All you watch is a television channels called FTR, all channel, including mine. Everybody you watch in India are FTR, free to air channel. You buy, do you get a newspaper free of cost? You don't get a free newspaper free of cost. You buy at 7, 8, 9, 10 rupees. But you don't pay a single rupee to see a television channel. You can see, said I pay to Cablewala, I pay to the Dish TV. That is your carrier fee. That is not your television viewing fee. So entire model is based on the revenue. So unless you can change it, which I don't know how to change it, there is no subscription model. So that is why most of the questions answer. Remember the word called FTA. Every television channel are free to air. That's why Netflix is now getting popular. Amazon Prime is getting popular. You pay and watch the thing which you want at your own convenient time.
So you got that answer from Ronaldo, which was a little negative. You could see the anger in him. Is because he's coming from his point of view, which is a very seasoned journalist. And I respect that because many of you, I've also seen that. You are a young chap. You want honest, pure journalism. Why are they not speaking the truth? I can see it. So what happens is that the traditional forms of media have this whole question of money a lot. And there is a lot of unhappiness or a little bit of, I think, disappointment. Because the audience, you guys, have to understand that everything can't be for free. And that is why the Netflix model, the crowdfunding model. I, as a matter of fact, run a YouTube channel and I have patrons as my subscribers. And my channel is completely crowdfunded. Now, is it possible in a news channel? Perhaps no, because the news channel is very, very, very expensive to run. A new business is very expensive to run. Can digital make that happen? Maybe. But as a youngster who has a very, very idealistic approach to journalism, please understand the problems that journalists have faced and continue to face. And money is only one thing. In today's India, you can be kidnapped, you can be shut down, you can be raided. There are so many things that can go wrong with you. Okay?
My question is, Kartikeya, since media is regarded as the fourth pillar of democracy, so do you think this fourth pillar is getting rusted?
Okay, is the fourth pillar getting rusted? Before Kartik answers, just one small question. All of you have done a little bit of constitutional studies? Yes, sir. Which article says that the media is the fourth pillar of democracy? Which section of the constitution? right? So before Kartike answers, please remember, you know, we bash journalists a lot. There is not one or that sets journalists apart. No security, there is no provision, there is... I'll just come to you. So just remember that a journal... And there was this whole debate during the framing of the constitution, but it was just said that the right to free speech will be implemented. So speech hai, I have the same thing. I can be charged under the same laws, I have no protection. Kartike.
See, I wouldn't say that, you know, the rust has entered the mainstream domain. You know, it's very easy to beat mainstream India. Mainstream media in America is being beaten by the supporters of Trump. It's happening in France. You know, in Austria, you have a 36-year-old premier beating the hell out of the mainstream media. No, it's not that. Please understand that, you know, when I was in college, I had no idea of a mobile phone. You know, the only thing which I did as a child was beam me up, Scotty, and that was with... you know, that was the idea of a wireless communication which I saw in a black and white Star Trek. Technology has changed the communication landscape. What has happened is that mainstream media had its own rules, its own procedures of vetting. For example, I as a correspondent when would work for magazines like The Week or when I was in Aaj Tak, the job was to put the facts out. There was no opinion. What has happened is, over a period of time, that democratization of opinion has taken place. A lot of people would say it has become very violent, women get trolled, there are rape threats and all that. But what has happened is it has allowed you to be part of an opinion narrative. 20 years back, it would have been very difficult for any person to say, please read my piece in this big newspaper, because that wouldn't be published. No one would publish you like that. So there is an opening up which has happened. And the opening up has happened on the social media because you have certain technological platforms like Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter. Now, these platforms have been married to certain formats. Earlier, the words were there. Then came the images. Now you have the videos. So, for example, now the political parties who feel that mainstream media does not cover them, they do a Facebook Live. They do a Twitter Live. So, you... can reach whomever you want. You can call it market, you can call it like-minded people, you can call it real journalism, you can call it real issue. It has allowed you. So certain terrains have opened up. It's an ongoing process. There are certain problems related to it. For example, it has created a world where you don't have a civilized debate. What you end up doing is you end up identifying people with similar views and you become part of it. So, Akash, you know, when we talk about mainstream media is jaded, even today, most of the rules are followed by mainstream media. It's, you know, this is something we have to understand because mainstream media has been pilloried right after 2011. And I think it's a global phenomenon right now because there are certain changes which have taken place globally. And India is not aloof from it.
Absolutely, absolutely. One final question before we go to the future. And how are we dealing with the future now?
Sir, my question is to all the panelists. Sir, we have to earn for our survival. But should you follow the media ethics or there is no social responsibilities or other moralities?
Okay, very, 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 you know, it's a question that bothers everybody. Very short answers to this. Social responsibility versus the economic viability of media. Is it all about business? And yes, business is important, but social responsibility, how can you marry that with good business sense? Is it possible? And ethics, obviously.
That goes without saying, actually. I think most of the media houses, socially, they have been responsible. I mean, there's hardly one or two aberrations in a year where you see that certain media would be actually irresponsible, but at the same time today, most of the irresponsible thing that comes out is from social media. It's not from main channel or a print newspaper. So therefore, I think like Karthikeyan just quoted about a story about what happened inside a flight. I mean, today each one of us, we are journalists, we are reporters, and most of the fake or morphed images or the news that goes viral, I think it's all of you are contributing, all of us are contributing. I mean, you can't put it just on certain media houses. So all of us need to be responsible, but otherwise we are doing fine actually.
So my question is very simple. So the topic we started this whole discussion was representation of Northeast in mainstream media. So I would like to ask that if a channel which is giving certain kind of news, it is for the viewers. If the viewers are not only interested to learn something or to know something about Northeast, then how can we include, how can the journalists be compelled to include something about Northeast in their media when the viewers are not only interested to watch?
Viewer apathy. Who wants to take that? Viewer apathy. Is the general viewer interested?
It's like a, okay, let me put it this way. You know, it's like a paradox, you know, when the earlier gentleman said, you know, responsibility. It's like imperatives of economic development and environmental sustainability. It's an eternal question. It's like this, you know, we all do that in our, you know, general life. We will talk about health food. We'll talk about eating healthy breakfast. But then viewership is also like that. So we'll say we'll give you a good program. It's a neat program, you know. It's classily done, you know. It has got all the camera angles right. The content is good. You'll appreciate it like health food. But you'll go back to puri, bhaji, alu, potato chips, Coca-Cola. Enjoy it. Sample a little bit of health food, but you'll go back to what you like. So please understand that, you know, when people write, they also reflect what is being read and liked. Now data has become democratic. We get the data. People who run newspapers, people who have their publications, they get their data. You know, people talk about the journalism is celebrity-centric. But tell me one thing, don't you agree that faces sell? If there is a face to the story, you'll immediately identify the story. Faceless stories are very difficult to sell. But if you have a Kangna Ranaut on a cover talking about politics, everyone will talk about it. But you have an NGO, a Megasays Award winner, talking about a problem of a village in Rajasthan, you'll say, okay, I saw it, good work, but you'll not get into the detail. So it's not only about responsibility of people who are there in the profession. They are also shaped by the feedback which they get from the civil society. It's a two-way process. No one is actually working in a vacuum. I sit here, I reflect what I understand is correct from you people.
Sure.
I don't operate in vacuum. Okay. You know, it's not like that. When you'll grow up, you'll understand no one operates in vacuum.
Okay.
People operate in context of each other.
So it's, of course, symbiotic, okay? You demand better journalism, you demand and you pay for good journalism and it will work. Some of the most quality journalism that we are getting to see are crowdfunded, are completely. The Ken, for example, is a website that gives you one story a day and you can't have anything for free. It's 2,000 rupees a year subscription. And they claim that it's working. So things are changing, and I want to end on that note with final comments. Starting from you, sir. Coming, sir. We all agree, I think the one thing that we've all agreed is that this whole mainstream media is bogus. We don't need this whole mainstream media. We don't need this new Delhi-ka attention. We are not vying for it. Going ahead, your quick points on how optimistic you are about the media in the Northeast and what's going to drive the media in the Northeast, in this region, because what we are seeing, at least in the South, I've witnessed to many of these channels that are economically viable, that are very popular, and nobody watches mainstream channels in the South. I think, is that the way we are heading here?
I think for the youngsters also, I think in the media industry, the important point is the audience. Now, you quoted example of South of India. Now, if you look at Tamil, now Tamil is the language in India, is the official language in Singapore, and spoken in Sri Lanka also. They have a large audience. So today, whatever channel we see from Guwahati, these are also national, not only national, these are international channels. So you are on DTH, you are watching the channel everywhere. Punjabi, you are watching in Punjab as well in Canada. So likewise in Bengali, when you talk of Bengal and then Bangladesh, we have huge population. Likewise, so therefore, more and more, as we go forward, what I see is that more and more decentralization will happen. More and more concentration will happen in so-called the regional side. So the concept, the misnomer that that we have been talking on mainstream, that balloon would be burst in the years to come. And insofar as Northeast is concerned, although you, I didn't correct you earlier, you said I'm in digital, though I'm in digital, but both my publishing, one is a magazine which is in print and another also is a daily paper which is in print.
Yeah.
Now for a region like Northeast, if you look at the IRS survey also, see Indian story is a different story. Globally, the print business is going down, but in India, the print business is going up. More so in a place like Northeast of India. Yeah, I see, at least for next 15, 20 years, I see a future for print. The reason why is because one, literacy rate is going up. If you look at it, I think from 1991, literacy rate in rural India was about 40%. Now 2011 is nearing 70%.
Sure.
So likewise, so there is still a gap to hit 100%. So with literacy rate going up, I expect more readership. One, two, with penetration of internet, another factor, another key driver, which will increase the potential of the media houses. Third, of course, the purchasing power parity that's going up with the growing economy. I mean, like Kartikeyan quoted, see, if you look at any of the FMCG companies also, the market share, or even the automobile companies, market share of any automobile company, if you look at it, the whole of Northeast, including Bengal, would never cross 20% at pan-India level. So same is the case as on today at India level when you talk about ad revenue.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I see a huge potential going forward.
Okay. Rinal sir, ending with you, sir, the future of media and how you see it, how things will progress. Print, digital?
I'd not like to end in a negative note. I believe that conventional media is dead. Agenda journalism is on. With the political narratives have almost killed every conventional mode of journalism. What I believe in your word, that some kind of crowdfunding, some kind of a different avenues, something in data form will come or has already come. But there is also a little bit of danger. Not little bit, it's quite a big danger because the ISPs, the internet service providers, are consolidating. Now there are only three forums. So once the entire consolidation takes place, three people will handle all the data which and goes to the 600 billion people. So whatever you do, it can be manipulated with algorithms very easily. So in the longer term, I don't see much great things, which will be more about what will be more big news and more news about what I see that his daughter is wearing for this birthday than the news which all the children and all the young people are what you want. So I personally again saying, ending that conventional media is dead. Agenda journalism has taken over. The political narratives of the country has destroyed everything. But there is a future. But that future is dependent upon how the consolidation of the internet service provider, how swiftly they do. If they don't do swiftly, it is good for us. But anyway, the eventuality, there are consolidation. You have already seen Vodafone and Idea merging.
Yes.
Airtel, Vodafone, Idea, OneCert, and then great Ambanis. So, you know.
Digital is not as democratic as it looks like.
I don't think it's not. Net is not democratic.
Fair point, absolutely. Kartik, a fine point.
There are two things I want to say. You know, I should have said this in the beginning. I disagree with words like Northeast, Southeast, South India, North India. When you use these words, you do not acknowledge diversity. Northeast is not about one state. You have Nagaland, you have Mizoram, you have Meghalaya. It's like South India. Is the food which is made in Kerala equal to what the Thevars eat in Chennai? Mm. Or is the Persian influence of food in Telangana is equal to the hot chilies used in Rayalaseema? Is that same? But then when you go to South India, Akash, you would have noticed there is something called Punjabi Thali. Mm. So anything north of... you go to South India, it says Punjabi Thali. You go to North India, it says South Indian tiffin, which is Idli Dosa. Do South Indians eat only Idli Dosa? So I do not like this word Northeast because I feel that you do not acknowledge the diversity. And I primarily think, I will not claim that I have seen whole of Northeast, but the biggest challenge of Northeast is not use. It is complete, Northeast needs to completely dissociate the developmental funds from electoral process. That is the biggest challenge of Northeast. You know, in this election, when I stayed in Nagaland, I saw big houses of all powerful politicians. But there was no road. You know, it took me hours and hours to reach Kohima from Dimapur. And later, my realization was that the funds to be used for the people was being used in electoral process. So that's where the challenge is. News is not the challenge. The challenge is to utilize the public fund for its people and not to be subsumed under the electoral process.
I think that's a very fair point, and I hope that the media itself is able to hold those politicians accountable. Many thanks for being a very patient audience on this one. We wrap up this session. There is a little bit of a... Afrida, there is a little bit of a...
Hey guys, press the bell icon and subscribe to our channel Inside Any to never miss any updates.